Keighley, and welcome to the Microsoft Theater for the Game Awards 2018.
Everyone, Geoff Keighley is a legend in the gaming industry. Like Jeff Gerstmann, Sotaro Iwata, or Sid Meier, his contributions to video games have elevated the art form to new standards of prominence and respect. From his earliest interviews with Gabe Newell to his latest role as creator of the E3 Coliseum experience, Keighley has leveraged his passion as a gamer and his position as an industry insider to champion video games in front of a global audience. The Game Awards is Keighley's grandest love letter to video games. He's had a long history of working on similar productions, starting with the oddly named Cybermania 94, the Ultimate Gamer Awards, and then continuing with 11 years as executive producer of the Spike Video Game Awards. But for the last 5 years, Keighley has had an award show of his own, one that is easily considered the premier award show for the industry. No one can question the dedication the man has for celebrating video games. However, with all that praise in mind, I do find the Game Awards to be an insult to the very art form it celebrates. Every year, I tune in hoping to see a celebration of the last 12 months in gaming. I expect an audience of developers and luminaries applauding the accomplishments of their peers, and I want to see dozens of awards front and center presented for a myriad of technical and artistic achievements. But instead, year after year, I see exclusive trailers sandwiched between commercials, and business executives brought on stage to hype next year's tentpole releases, and fans cheering on soulless branding, so much branding on everything from award category names to co-hosts. And finally, to add insult to injury, awards that are presented off-screen or in rapid-fire fashion because God forbid they take airtime away from a trailer.
And the Game Award for Best Audio Design, Best Art Direction, Best Mobile Game, Best VR-AR Game, and Astrobot Rescue Mission is the winner for Best VR-AR Game. Congratulations.
I admit that this topic gets me rather heated. Maybe I'm taking the whole awards thing too seriously. There are, after all, plenty of other organizations that give out end-of-the-year awards for video games, and nothing about the Game Awards says it's the final arbiter on the matter. On the other hand, I want to take the Game Awards seriously, because I believe in video games as an art form. Like any other aesthetic medium, video games are an opportunity to teach and to feel and to experience and to communicate between human beings. I love the idea of a high-profile event that focuses on the creators and the creations that have moved the medium forward. They deserve to be celebrated and rewarded for their accomplishments. But the Game Awards, with its emphasis on world premiere trailers and other marketing techniques, is focused too much on the future. It wants to tease us with what could come next rather than praise what has already been made. And quite frankly, that is incredibly disrespectful. There is an enormous difference between a scripted trailer and a fully realized video game. No Man's Sky and Killzone 2 proved that. So when Keighley decides to present trailers and awards side by side, it belittles the hard work of artists, coders, designers, and producers. An award show is meant to heap praise on fully realized creations and not tease glimpses of the unfinished. There is another point I'd like to bring up, one that makes me feel a bit uncomfortable, but it needs to be said. Presenting future games at an award show and then later nominating those same games for an award is kinda scummy. To be clear, I don't think there is some smoke-filled room where conspiratorial deals are taking place, nor am I calling into question the honesty of the voting jury. But I do think presenting marketing campaigns in an award show paints the entire industry as only caring about revenue and not the artists themselves.
And the Game Award goes to...
Fortnite.
Thor, he's back. That kid on the TV just called me a dickhead again.
And in terms of fairness, games that are shown on the stage are more likely to get future coverage and reviews, and therefore more likely to get nominated for next year's awards. Choosing which trailers to show is kind of like picking favorites. Objectivity, both in practice and appearance, is one of the most important elements of an awards show. Showing trailers at all is completely counterintuitive. And I don't think Keighley understands that. I'm still going to watch the Game Awards this year. I can't help myself. Heck, we'll probably even do a live watch along of it. Because beyond all the advertising and questionable production decisions, I still like to see the awards. I like to see the people who helped make the best games in 2019 get their moment in the spotlight. And I love to see them get the applause they deserve. I just wish the show itself was better.
Hydrobot, taking it to the next level, that was sick!
Oh,
Hello there. You've caught me practicing my reading. Boy, I sure wish I wasn't illiterate. Clearly you've enjoyed another Subpixel video. If you could like, comment, or subscribe, it lets us and it lets YouTube know that our content is worth watching. In the meantime, I'm gonna get back to pretending.